first you guys on Sunday night find out you're going to be going to Chestnut Hill, you're going to be taking on Denver in your first game. What were kind of your initial reactions to that draft?
Yeah, I think it's just exciting to see your name on the screen, even though that we knew it was going to pop up. We had a feeling we'd be at Boston College. We just didn't know who our opponent would be. And, you know, we had to learn a lot about Denver. I knew a little bit about them just from kind of social media and following them and their success this season. But it's been enjoyable watching them on film the past couple days and learning more about their offense and defense.
Yeah, is it a little bit of an interesting scenario wherein you guys are playing a team? It's been a number of years, but it is a team that you guys have, well, I don't know, you were the coach in 2017.
Yeah, yeah.
You saw them. Is that something that makes it a little bit easier to prepare, knowing just having somewhat of a basis?
Yeah, maybe a little bit, but obviously, you know, no one is still on our team from that year, so we definitely kind of see them more as a new opponent that is more unfamiliar than not.
What are some of the things that the Pios do well that you guys are kind of preparing for?
Yeah, they have a great offense. They have three strong offensive players who put up a ton of shots and points for them and are a big part of the reason they've had the success that they've had this year. They've got a great defense as well. You know, it's different. It's a zone defense. So you just have to prepare a little bit different rather than kind of maybe focusing on everything that you do and what you've done to get to this point. You got to kind of change up some things and making sure that your team is just aware of what we're looking for. But I'm just glad that we have, you know, four solid days to be able to prepare for them and have a ton of belief and trust in our girls to get it done.
How cool is it to have the opportunity to play against a team that's in one of these power conferences, the Denver is in the Big East?
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, Denver has done a great job making themselves a lacrosse name, and we're all very aware of them. So just to be on the same field as them and knowing we can compete with them is great. But I think, you know, we're just excited for the opportunity to have another week together, play another game, and feel really good going into this game that we can have a great game.
Is that anything that's kind of factored into the just mental aspect of the game that you guys maybe have a little bit of an edge in terms of that?
Yeah, we might. You know, I think we kind of more think of what we get to do, but we're certainly aware they're, you know, like you said, flying across the country. You know, I know they're flying into Boston either tonight or tomorrow night, from what I have heard in the call that I was on yesterday. But, you know, they're going to be ready. They have that experience, and, you know, we're two teams of 29 that still get this chance to play, and we're all looking to win right now.
Is there a feeling that, for a lot of kind of mid-major teams, when you get into a situation like this and you're playing against a power conference champion, there's maybe a feeling of sometimes people can be a little bit overwhelmed, but you guys play against a team that's seeded every year. Does that kind of help give you a little bit of confidence going into this one that it's not something that you're completely, like, stepping up in class compared to what you normally play?
Yeah, I think we feel really good about, you know, what we have to work with and what we can do on offense and defense and really all over the field. And I think just relying heavily on our game experience of, you know, really I think kind of the past four games we've been able to be in some great situations that have challenged us, and some of them we didn't always come out on top of, and really learn a lot about ourselves. And I think all that stuff is going to prepare us for going into this game, you know, regardless of the name on their jersey, but just those moments where you're down or you're up or those close games, I think all that stuff allows us to feel confident in those moments and to know that there's, you know, things that we can do about them.
Do you guys feel a little bit like you're playing with house money? Are you guys able to be a little bit loose going into this, just given what you've already been able to do?
Yeah, I think so. I think you know, even that championship game, I think we were able to play a little bit loose, although we know there was a lot on the line, and we definitely didn't have, like, you know, the prettiest game out there in terms of turnovers and finishing on our shots or defensive stops. But just knowing that we've gotten this far, I think there's a huge kind of weight off our shoulders. And at the same time, like, we won a championship, and we 100% earned and deserved that. And I think that builds a lot of confidence when you're working with the group that we have. Yeah, we all know who Boston College is and are, and the players on their team, and it's hard not to to follow their success. And the ACC is the best lacrosse conference in our sport right now. And so to know that we are in the kind of that same pool as them, and if we win, we have an opportunity to be on the same field as them. You know, again, those are things that our girls are all very, very aware of, and just it's just great knowing that we're making history for our program. And you know, the first time that we've even won a conference game, let alone two, and get a championship, and now going to the NCAA tournament, you have to kind of take a step back and realize all the history that we've made this year.